The easiest way to learn fiqh is to start with one madhab and not to confuse, you know, by going into all madhabs at one time. Step by step, okay? Choose whatever madhab you want, Hanafi, Shafi'i, Hanbali, Maliki. Take the small book that they start with in fiqh, which lists all the rulings of fiqh. Tahara, Salat, Siyam, Zakat, all the rulings, without mentioning any proofs and anything, okay? And memorize whatever you want from them, okay? And khalas, if it is a Shafi'i book, you are a Shafi'i. If it is a Hanafi book, you are a Hanafi, and so on. No. Later on, if you want to expand and go more, then you go and see the proofs for those rulings in the same madhab. Then you go to another madhab if you want, or a combination of all madhabs, and compare and look at their proofs and all that. But this is at a very late stage, okay?
But it is not of utmost importance right now, or it does not...
It's important that you act based on following scholars, okay? Yani, one should not follow his own desire and his own understanding just like that, you know? A lot of people nowadays, unfortunately, when they want to be obedient servants of Allah, they think that is a passport for them to think as they like, understand as they like, and do what they like. No. You have to limit yourself to the scholars of Al-Sunnah. You cannot just make up your own opinions and do things from here and there, and what you like, you think is right, and all that. No. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask those who are knowledgeable. Ahl al-Dhikr are the scholars.
But if you are just a Muslim and you don't follow any scholars like Imam Ahmad, Imam Shafi'i?
No, you have to have to follow scholars, but you don't have to follow those four. If you follow a scholar who is existing nowadays, okay, or some scholars, that's enough, okay?
Should he be following another scholar who is following Imam Ahmad?
He would not be a scholar if he was not. He would be a devil if he was making his own thing. He would be a devil. Okay, a scholar is the one, as Imam Ahmad rahimahullah once said to someone, "Don't say anything without an imam in this issue. Yani without some scholar who have said it before you. Okay, this is the way." Those who come up with opinions nowadays, without looking back where, who said it, what scholar said it, they are devils, okay? Or they are ignorance.
Sheikh, what about the Mujaddidun that will come every
time? The Mujaddid is different. He is a special kind of scholar. The Prophet ﷺ said, يَبْعَثُ اللَّهُ عَلَى رَأْسِ كُلِّ مِئَةِ عَامٍ مَنْ يُجَدِّدْ أمر هذه الأمة أمر هذه الأمة or something like that. نعم. So the مجدد at the top of each 100 years, a scholar will revive something that the Muslims have forgotten. Okay. Sometimes this thing is tawheed itself.
So in this case, isn't it that certain things can change with time?
The knowledge of the people can change, but the truth is there. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikr wa inna lahu lahafizun. The religion is protected by Allah. Maybe the majority of the people might not know it, but it's still there. There was a time in which even the Arab Peninsula, even Mecca and Medina, were worshipping idols, graves, okay? Everywhere, not only in Egypt and India and Africa, there, no, everywhere. In Riyadh, they had qabr of the grave of Zayd ibn al-Khattab, and they were worshipping the grave, okay? So, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the strength to Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab to revive Tawheed for them.
Okay.
So this is the point.
What about the rest kind of faith? And if the Muslim completed all these kinds of faith, his faith will be completed?
The faith, you have obligatory things and you have desirable things. If you complete all the obligatory, and do the obligatory things, stay away from the haram, then you are mu'min, faithful. If you go beyond that and do the obligatory and then non-obligatory, desirable things, and stay away from haram and makruh, okay, you are muhsin. This is higher than iman. If you have shortcomings, you live as a Muslim, but you do bad things and you do good things, but you are still a Muslim, then you are a Muslim, okay? ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمُقْتَصِدْ وَسَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَةِ. All Muslims, okay? Okay, the lunch is ready, so... يا رب. السلام عليكم. كيف الحال؟ أنا عادة أنا أمشي بسرعة والله، إذا عندك شيء بسرعة هذا.
Not necessarily.
But make sure that the understanding of the hadith is what the scholars say. Yeah, okay.
No.